We know that Wizards Unite is going to take place sometime after the last Harry Potter books. I never got to read the books growing up, so this was a perfect opportunity for me to dive into them and to read them for the first time. Along with reading them for the first time, I will be re-watching all of the movies. I am breaking down each book into its highlights so that we can all get caught up and we can go into Wizards Unite knowing what's going on. Just as a disclaimer, I'm not going to be going over everything that happens in the books and the movies. I'm just hitting really quick highlights so that we can all catch up. And especially the stuff that I think is important or will be important when we are playing Wizards Unite. Now, let's dive into the first book, The Philosopher's Stone. One of the first things we learn is that Harry Potter's parents are dead. He is all alone. Harry has to now live with his aunt, uncle, and cousin, who are the worst humans you can imagine. We find out that Harry is a wizard. Harry goes to a wizarding school called Hogwarts. Harry then quickly meets his two best friends of the series, Hermione and Ron. One of the first things that happens at Hogwarts is the first year students get an old hat put on top of them called the sorting hat. And what it does is it sorts them into one of four different houses at Hogwarts. Harry gets put into the Gryffindor house. We also learn that Malfoy is a huge jerk. Harry is really good at flying on a broomstick. He is super quick and nimble and is recruited for the Quidditch team. Quidditch is a wizard sport played on broomsticks. You're flying around trying to score points. You're trying to catch the golden snitch. While walking around Hogwarts, Harry and his best friends run into a giant three-headed dog hiding in a room that is on top of a cellar door. Hermione, Ron, and Harry figure out that the three-headed dog is guarding the Philosopher's Stone. They think Snape is trying to find the Philosopher's Stone so that he can resurrect Voldemort. Oh yeah, there's this guy called Voldemort. He's a really bad wizard that killed Harry Potter's family and tried to kill baby Harry Potter. Harry, Hermione, and Ron figure out how to get past the huge three-headed dog. They fall into the caves and tunnels under the school and pass through a few rooms with tests to stop people from getting to the Philosopher's Stone. Harry makes it to the final room to find out that it's not Snape who is after the stone, but Professor Quill, who has Voldemort on the back of his head. Pretty freaky. Harry gets the stone and fends off Quill, since when Quill touches Harry, it burns him. They both pass out and Dumbledore shows up and everything is good. Oh yeah, Dumbledore is a super strong wizard who is head over Hogwarts. When Harry awakes, Dumbledore tells him that the Philosopher's Stone has been destroyed because it is too powerful in the wrong hands. Because of everything Harry, Hermione, and Ron do, Gryffindor wins the House Cup. Everyone is super excited. And now it's time for summer break. All right, that was Harry Potter really quick. That was such an awesome adventure. I loved reading the book and catching up again with the movies. So much fun. Let me know in the comments what your favorite part of the Philosopher's Stone is. And if you think I left anything out of the highlights, that is going to be really important to know while we'll be playing Wizards Unite. As always, make sure to subscribe so that you can get all of the latest news and updates for Wizards Unite. You can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram. The links will be in the description. I hope you're having a great day. Bye!